And now on to a story that we are very closely following at Mirror Now. The Aadhaar data leaks case, as exposed by daily newspaper The Tribune. A sting operation carried out by the newspaper allegedly exposed how personal data of nearly a billion citizens is up for grabs illegally for a mere 500 rupees. Now, after the expose by The Tribune, an FIR has been filed against the newspaper. In response, journalists and citizens across India have now come together. Let's listen in to some of the reactions on this case that have come in through the day.
Government's move to book that journalist for exposing all wrongdoings in that UIDAI department, I think this is again an attack on the freedom of press, and somewhere government, instead of appreciating that journalist for exposing all those wrongdoings, they have tried to gag the media voice, and we strongly condemn that the registration of FIR. The persons who were involved in all those wrongdoings must be booked. Police must investigate and let government come out with an action against all those employees or officials who were involved in that scam.
There have been reservations in different institutions, including the institution of media, with regard to this unique identification process. There have been stories in the press also that certain people's security and other personal details have fallen into unsafe hands. The government will have to make some reassuring statements, and some steps will have to be taken. I don't think that the media fraternity in this country will accept the way this journalist has been booked.
It is role of the media to get all the information to the masses, and through them to the various state agencies and the judiciary. In such a situation, our reporter is filing a report. If you have any doubt about that, you can give a clarification next day. You can give a clarification, this is not the situation. But you cannot file an FIR. Broadcast Editor Association demands that they should immediately withdraw this FIR, failing which the Broadcast Editors Association, other journalistic bodies will take the appropriate measure.
You can shoot the messenger. It's not going to solve the problem. The problem is not going away. It's only proving to the UAID that there is a problem. They kept on telling the whole world that there is no problem, this data is perfectly safe, but it isn't. It's now been proved. It has leaked before, it has leaked again, and now the entire 1.2 billion data has been leaked. What this is a security lapse, for the a big security breach for the country. Instead of looking inwards and apologizing for whatever it is, the difference between their promise and performance, they are saying they will shoot the messenger.
Firstly, this FIR is not limited to a journalist. It is about unauthorized access, which, if has come into the public domain, is a huge area of contention vis-a-vis cyber crime. She is part of the investigation. I'm sure she herself has said, no, but she herself has said that as part of the investigation, she'd be happy to cooperate. But if there is a question of unauthorized access, why shouldn't everyone cooperate with the authorities? That is my limited point.
Well, but the government, in fact, has reassured that it is committed to the freedom of the press. Union Minister for Law and Justice Information Technology, Ravi Shankar Prasad, has tweeted, and I quote, "The government is fully committed to the freedom of press as well as to maintaining security and sanctity of hashtag Aadhaar for India's development. FIR is against unknown. I've suggested at UIDAI to request Tribune and its journalists to give all assistance to the police in investigating the real offenders."